क्वालिटी इम्प्रूवमेंट इन मैथ एजुकेशन प्रोजेक्ट वीडियो बेस्ड पीपीटी प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक नेम ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन दैट इज द लीनियर इक्वेशन माय नेम इज नागेश शंकर वांगकर एंड रजिस्ट्रेशन नंबर इज A064 माय स्कूल नेम इज श्री सारंग स्वामी विद्यालय परभणी डिस्ट्रिक्ट परभणी स्टेप नंबर 1 ऑब्जर्व एंड एक्सप्लोर In this step, just we will see a video In real life, we can use linear equation in many situations. For that, here one activity is there. Activity number first. In a classroom, teacher bought a mango and apple and shows to students. And explain about that prizes. Teacher said, shopkeeper did not give me the price of each fruit, but he collected rupees 16 from him. Now, teacher asked two students, tell about the cost of each fruit. Students gave several answers, like some students said, rupees 3 is the cost of mango and 13 is the cost of apple. Like this, the pairs of many costs is there, like 5, 5 and 11, 6 and 10, 7 and 9 and so on. But all of that is not correct because we don't know the cost of each fruit. That exact cost of each fruit is unknown for us. Now, for that unknown quantity, let us take a variable to find the cost of each fruit and consider the cost of one mango be x and cost of one apple be y. So, the sum of these two costs is 16. Student knows the total cost, that is 16. Hence, x plus y is equal to 16. This equation is formed. Now, here this x plus y is the left hand side and 16 is the right hand side. But here the degree of these variables is 1. The degree of x is also 1 and the degree of y is also 1. So this type of equation is called the linear equation in two variables. Now teacher plot these points on the graph paper and shows what will be the graphical representation of these points, and the graphical representation of this equation is a straight line. Now this is also one reason to call these equations as a linear equation. The equations is called the linear equation whose graph is straight line. Again, till now we don't know the cost of each fruit, because just we represent graphically for that one equation only. Now this activity continue further. Another student bought two mangoes and one apple from same shop and paid 22 rupees for it. Student notes, unknown cost for a mango is x rupees and for an apple is rupees y. So mathematical statement will be 2x plus y is equal to 22. Again teacher asked about the cost of each fruit. Now can you tell, ask to students, can you tell me the cost of each fruit? Again student give several answers, like rupees 3 is the cost of mango and 16 is the cost of apple. If rupees 3 is the cost of mango, then for 2 mangoes 6 rupees is there, and that 6 and 16 is 22. Like that some pairs, students told some pairs. Again teacher asked to plot these points on graph paper and see the graphical representation of this. Then on that same paper, then we got another straight line, and these two lines intersects in one point only, and the coordinates of that intersection of that point is the answer of our question, and the coordinates are x is equal to 6 and y is equal to 10. Now x is equal to 6 means x is the cost of one mango and y is the cost of one apple. That means student got the answer of cost of a mango is rupees 6 and the cost of an apple is rupees 10. That means to find the exact value of any quantity, we need pair of a linear equation, and the system of pair of this linear equation is called the simultaneous linear equation. We can use these simultaneous linear equations in real life examples also. Now step number 2, define and prove. In this step we will see some definitions. First, an equation in two variables x and y is said to be linear equation if it is of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where a, b and c are real numbers, that is a is not equal to 0 and b is not equal to 0. Again the definition number 2, that is simultaneous linear equation. When we consider two linear equations in two variables simultaneously, then these equations are called simultaneous linear equation. Again, when the solution of simultaneous linear equation, if you put that value of variables in that equation, equations get satisfied, and both the equations get satisfied simultaneously. That's why these equations are called simultaneous linear equation. Here to solve simultaneous linear equation, there are some methods of solving simultaneous linear equations. First one is the graphical method, and second one is the algebraic method. In algebraic method, again there are three sub methods are there, that elimination by substitution, second one is elimination by equating the coefficients, and third one is the determinant method. We can say that is the Cramer's rule. Now there are conditions of consistency of equations. If a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0, these are the two equations. Here a1, b1, c1 and a2, b2, c2 are the coefficients of in these two equations. If you take the ratios of these coefficients in each condition, we will get some conclusions. If we take the ratio of a1 by a2 and compare it with b1 by ratio of b1 by b2, and if we get a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, By getting this condition, we can get the conclusions about the solutions, about the graphical representation, and about the consistency of this equation. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then the number of solutions for such equations is a unique solution, and the graphical representation is intersecting lines, and hence this type of equations are called consistent equations. Condition number 2, if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but that ratios are not equal to c1 by c2, then these type of equations has no solution, and the graphical representation of such type of equation is a parallel lines, and hence such type of equation is called inconsistent equations. Now, condition number 3, if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, that means the ratio of all coefficients are equal, then such type of equations have infinitely many solutions, and the graphical representation of such type of equations is the coincident lines, that means overlapping lines, and hence this type of equations is called the consistent equations. Now, step number 3, apply and evaluate. In this step, we have some examples which are used in real life. Some solved examples are here, and some examples for practice also here. Here, example number first, 2-digit number is 3 more than 6 times the sum of its digits. If 18 is added to number obtained by interchanging the digits, we get the original number. We have to find that original number. For the solution of this, let us the digit in tens place be x and the digit in units place be y. The original number become from these two digits, that is 10 into tens place digit plus 1 into units place digit, that means 10x plus y. According to the first condition, the equation became like this: 10x plus y is equal to 6 in bracket x plus y plus 3. By solving this, we will get 4x minus 5y is equal to 3. Give it to equation number 1. Now, if the digits interchange, the number gets reversed. That means our number become like this: 10y plus x. Now, according to the second condition, our equation become like this: 10y plus x plus 18, that is equal to 10x plus y. Now, solving first and second equations, we will get x is equal to 7 and y is equal to 5. Hence, the original number is 75. This second equation is here. Madhulika and Rita ran a 2-kilometer race twice. Rita completed the first round 2 minutes earlier than Madhulika. But in second round, Madhulika increased her speed by 2 km per hour and Rita reduced her speed by 2 km per hour. Madhulika finished 2 minutes earlier than Rita. Find their speeds of running in the first round. To solve this example, let's consider the speed of Madhulika and Rita. Let the speed of Madhulika be x km per hour and the speed of Rita be y km per hour. Here, the comparison between speeds is given. So, calculate speeds. Comparison between that time is given. That's why find the time taken by Madhulika and time taken by Rita. So, time required to complete that race for Madhulika, that is 2 by x, and to Rita, that is 2 by y. The difference between that time is 2 minutes. Convert that minute into hours. That's why our equation become like this: 2 by x minus 2 by y is equal to 2 by 60. Here, by simplifying that, we will get 60 in bracket y minus x is equal to xy. Now, in second round, Madhulika increased her speed. Hence, her speed now be x plus 2 km per hour. And in second round, Rita reduced her speed. Now, her speed become y minus 2 kilometer per hour. According to second condition, 2 divided by y minus 2 minus 2 divided by x plus 2 is equal to 2 by 60. By solving this, we get again a simple equation, that is 60 in bracket y minus x minus 2x plus 2y minus 4. Here, xy is equal to 60 in bracket y minus x. By substituting the values and calculating these, we will get two equations again. That is x plus y is equal to 22 and x minus y is equal to minus 4. By solving that, we get x is equal to 10. By substituting that value in equation, we get y is equal to 10. Hence, the speed of Madhulika kilometer per hour and the speed of kilometer per hour. Again, some examples which are solved. Now, one example. See, we will see this example for practice. A railway half ticket costs half the full fare, but the reservation charges are same on a half ticket as on full ticket. One passenger reserves for ticket from station A to C. Cost is 2125 rupees. Also, one passenger reserves first class ticket and one reserve half ticket from station A to station B, and for that rupees 3200 is the cost. Find the full fare from station A to station B and also find the reservation charges for the ticket. Here, to solve this example, this is the example related with real life. Here, let's consider the cost for full fare be rupees x and the reservation charges be rupees y. Here, in first condition, that is given, one passenger reserved first class ticket from station A to B. That means for that, the charges of full fare of rupees x plus reservation charges, because he reserved that ticket, reservation charges y. That means the first equation become like this, x plus y is equal to rupees 2125. Now, for the second condition, one passenger reserved first class ticket and again one reserved half first class ticket from A to B. In second condition, for the first class ticket, full fare charge is x, but that is also reserved, so x plus y. Again, one reserved half first class ticket, that means the half fare of that is x by 2, but that is also reservation ticket, hence x plus x by 2 plus y is equal to 3200. That means the equation become x plus y plus x by 2 plus y is equal to 3200. By solving these two equations, we get the full fare, that means the value of x, is rupees 2100 and the reservation charges is rupees 25. Thanks.